Anne Murray is classic.
To me, she's the barefoot Canadian, you know, the phys ed teacher, the woman with a golden voice.
She's a million notes tied with a red bow. And when she opens her mouth, it's just, the room fills up with ribbon.
She's earthy, she's solid, she's direct. I don't know, she's Anne Murray.
The 6 o'clock alarm would never ring, but it rings and we rise, wipe the sleep out of our eyes. Your shaving razor's cold and it stays. Cheer up, Sleepy Jean. Oh, daydream believer and a homecoming queen. I once thought of you as a white knight on the steed. Now you know how happy we can be. Oh, and our good time started then without dollars. But how much, baby, do we really need? Cheer up, Sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming queen? George. What can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming
One day, I got a phone call from Bruce Allen, my manager, who nervously told me there was going to be a meeting at EMI, and would I please attend? And it was, and I said, well, what's it about? And he said, well, they're talking about you're doing another album. I said, I don't want to do another album. And he said, well, will you just hear us out? They've got some good ideas, Anne. They got some good ideas. I think you'll be interested. And I said, Bruce, I'm not interested. Well, will you just do me a favor? Will you just come to the meeting? So I said, okay. I went to the meeting. And they suggested a duets album. And I went, I don't know. It doesn't sound right to me. Within an hour, I had my arm twisted. And, well, maybe. Okay, let's give it a try. So, I'm an easy mark. The CD was cut in four cities. It was cut in Los Angeles, Nashville, New York, and Toronto. And the first place we went was Los Angeles. The first person I worked with was Olivia Newton-John.
I love Anne Murray. I've always loved her voice. I think she's got the most beautiful, rich, gorgeous voice with perfect pitch, and I've always liked her as a person too, so I was thrilled to be asked.
We just hit it off right away. First of all, the song was very light and an easy one to sing. It was Gordon Lightfoot's Cotton Jenny.
And the wheel of love goes round as love go around. Love go around. Love go around.
those two lines are tough. Yeah.
Love go round. Love go round. Yeah. Ooh,
yeah. Daydream Believer was one of the few up-tempo songs on this album because I'm a ballad girl from way back. And this was perfect for Nelly because Nelly does those light, fun kind of songs.
Oh, I could hide 'neath the wings of the blue.
I don't think I could do anything more distinctly Canadian than record a duet with Anne Murray, and it's an honor. It's funny because when I was playing these demos and kind of getting familiar with her catalog in the last couple of weeks, I'd be playing it, you know, in the kitchen with friends or whatever, and I'd see a tear, you know, come to some of their eyes, and they'd feel emotional and not be sure why. And I think it's because their parents grew up listening to Anne in their homes.
Cheer up, sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming queen?
The other thing that Anne and I really related on is she's a mother. She's got two children, and I've got a daughter, and she's experienced the whole international travel with her children. I was actually, you know, thanking Anne for putting in all those years because she's paved the way and made the journey a lot easier for females like me.
Things were very different for me than they are for these girls. When I was raising my children, I was very private about their being in the public eye, and I kept them away from all of that. And I was trying to separate my life and my career. I was trying to do that. It's impossible to do. It's tough for the kids. One kid wanted to be dropped off two blocks from school. The other kid wanted me to drive by with the top down in the car. It's funny how different kids react differently, you know. I did my best, but for the most part, I was guilt-ridden. But they both seem to still like me, for which I'm very grateful.
Do you want me to go, the dreams come true?
I was certainly excited to be recording with her because I love to record with her. She's a blast to be around in life. And she's a blast to be around in the studio. And now that I'm a bit older, we're able to share musically.
I knew that Dawn was musical. I knew that both of my children were musical, but I didn't think they were out of the ordinary.
The day my mom sort of realized that I could sing was I had been to karaoke the night before until 4 o'clock in the morning, and what happens is they give you a recording of what you've sung. Well, I sang Bonnie Raitt's Something to Talk About, and I came to my mother and I said, well, here's what we did last night you want to hear.
I played it over and over and over in disbelief at how this could happen when you were 18 and you wouldn't have noticed it before. So it was like a miracle because this was an extraordinarily good voice.
The idea came from my mother to sing Nobody Loves Me Like You Do. And at first I didn't think that it didn't seem appropriate to me because I had heard it as a song between a man and a woman and not between a mother and a child.
And yet when she got into the studio and we did it, it was kind of magical. And I felt it, and so did she. And she said, oh, I think that went okay. I said, yes, I think so.
It was very emotional for me. I really got it, I think, when we were recording. I think that's the first day that I really understood the song.
Like a candle burning bright,
Love is glowing in your eyes, a flame to light our way that burns brighter every day. Now I have you, and nobody loves me like you do. Like a leaf upon the wind, I could find no place to land, dream the hours away, wandered every day. I was a song still unsung, a poem with no rhyme, a dancer out of time. But now there's you. Nobody loves me like you do. What if I'd never met you? Where would I be right now? Funny how life just falls in place somehow. Touch my heart in places that I never even do. Nobody loves me. Nobody loves me. Nobody loves me like you do. Nobody loves me like you do.
I have done a lot of duets in my career, from the Glenn Campbell Show right on through. But one of the highlights was in 1992, the first time I sang with Katie Lang. We did a television show called Country Gold.
I wanna sing you love.
It was pretty easy, although I was pretty in awe of her, you know, being in her presence after so long of being a fan. Anne Marie has been a huge influence, starting when I was about 7 years old. So, you know, from her low, rich voice to her bare feet and to, you know, the fact that she's was a Canadian superstar, really, really an indelible impression on me.
When I first heard Katie Lang sing, I thought to myself, oh my God, that voice, it reminded me of my own voice. We're almost like siblings. The sound is so similar. It's that that fat, round sound that we both have.
Singing with her now, I realized how much her voice influenced me and how much I emulated certain parts of her vocal approach. And she's just a beautiful woman, you know. She's different than the rest of the female singers out there, and you know, she was somebody I, you know, was in love with for my whole life.
You've been practicing.
Yes, I have been.
You know this song.
Well, I've heard it once or twice.
You sing it pretty good yourself.
Thanks.
She did write me a letter when she was 8 or 9 years old, and I never did answer it. And she was pretty upset about that. And has mentioned it several times since.
I do, yeah. I bring it up often. I was trying to make her feel guilty.
Peaceful feeling of my home. I want to show you the peaceful feeling of my home.
That was great. I can't even tell you the first time that I met Jann Arden. The first sort of event that happened was she was on the radio talking to Peter Zosky about having met me at the Junos, and perhaps that's the first place we met, was at the Juno Awards. And she went on and on about how I had this phony leg. How I have these legs that I unscrewed. And she went on and on about all of this business.
And I also said that she was drunk, and her mother heard this radio interview, and she was just going off about Jann Arden, and what the heck is she talking about? And she was saying all these things.
So I get this phone call from my mother saying, who was that girl on the radio? I heard this girl on the radio saying you were drunk at the Junos. Were you drunk at the Junos? I said, no, Mom. I was Jann Arden.
Fast forward now. My record's done well. I'm getting an award. I get this note in this long, long box that shows up. I open up the card, and it's from Anne. One of the record guys handed it to me. She said, sorry I couldn't be there. Congratulations. I know you've had a great year. And I opened this box, and it was a leg, a mannequin leg, which I still have as well. She sent me her leg. She goes, I may need this back. Ping, this thing pops up one day, and she goes, you probably won't recognize this email, but it's Anne, and I'm doing this Duets record, and she just left a short message of, you know, I'm really interested in having you come and sing a song with me. And I think I read that about 19 times. You know, you scroll up and down, up and down, up and down, and look at the address, and is that really her? And so she said, just give me a call, or here's my number, and I phoned, and she had a song in mind, which is, you know, Somebody's Always Saying Goodbye, which is just, I'm so glad that I got that song.
I'm going to put this other.
I'm talking about hair dye right now.
When she came into the studio, I mean, it was just one laugh from the moment we started recording until the end.
I forgot to tell you about my nut allergy.
I thought it would be one of those diva things where, you know, she'll do her part. We'll get your part in Red Deer. When you're in Red Deer, Jann, we'll have you come in, and you can hear Anne sing, and you can sing your little part. I never dreamed that I'd be showing up, you know, with Phil, the producer, and Anne, and in the room singing it live.
Well, that's the way I do it, Jann. I sing the song live.
Okay. So, yeah, it was just crazy. I'm thinking, I'm glad I wasn't in Red Deer, but yeah, there she was, Anne Murray, singing 2 feet from my head.
Railway station, midnight trains, lonely airports in the rain. Somebody stands there with tears in their eyes.
It's the same old sea, time after time. That's the trouble with all mankind.
Somebody's always saying goodbye. Tail lights. Someone's leaving, and someone's left behind.
I don't know how it got that way, but every place you look these days,
somebody's always saying goodbye. Take two people like me and you. We could have made it, we just quit too soon.
All the two of us, we could have had it all
if we'd only tried.
Taxi cabs that leave in the night, Greyhound buses with red tail lights.
Someone's leaving, someone's left behind.
But that's the way love is, it seems.
Just when you've got a real good thing, somebody's always goodbye. Somebody's always saying goodbye.
The duet with Celine Dion has got to be the most memorable, or certainly the scariest, of all the duets I've ever had. Celine had kindly agreed to come and do this duet with me on stage in Montreal. It's a live show, and but she had just flown in from Europe and needed to get some sleep before she came in at night to perform with me. So she sent her background singer to the rehearsal, and the background singer had a cell phone, and we rehearsed it with the background singer singing Celine's part, with Celine singing into her ear, and I never did hear Celine. So when she walked out on stage that night, we had not rehearsed for all intents and purposes, and she was a surprise guest. Nobody knew she was coming. And I did the first verse, and on she walked. And from then on, it was flying by the seat of my pants. And I had to follow her because I was singing the harmony.
When I give my heart, it will be completely. Oh, I'll never give my heart. I can feel that.
when I fall in love with you.
Came off without a hitch, and the song that you hear on this album was the first take. Pretty good.
Thank you so much.
I'll treat you 10 of your cities for Marion Bridge and the pleasure.
I wanted an opportunity to do this song. And Celtic Woman, I had seen them on PBS so many times doing their Christmas shows and things like that, and I thought they would be ideal for this song.
Can you imagine a piece of the universe more fit for princes and kings? I'll trade you 10 of your cities for Marion Bridge and the pleasure.
My dad is a huge fan of Anne Murray's, and one of his favourite songs was Could I Have This Dance for the Rest of My Life, so I can remember singing it in the car with him. So we were really thrilled when we heard that we were going to be part of this project with Anne.
I mean, she's such a great crossover artist as well, and she's, you know, won so many Grammys, and, you know, we really look up to her, actually, and it's really a thrill for us to be here.
Going to be with them, I'm going to be with them.
For me, doing a duet with Dusty was really the icing on the cake for this album, because I had completely forgotten that she had recorded I Just Fall in Love Again. And I think the rumor is, or the story is that her record company went belly up and the song never got released. And my song did and became a hit for me. So somewhere out there was a track by Dusty Springfield. And we went searching for it, found it, and I had my duet with Dusty Springfield. It was a thrill. I did speak to her just before she died. We had a long conversation and kind of went over old times, and we said goodbye. My daughter Dawn was born on Dusty Springfield's 40th birthday. So when we were to do this thing live, I thought that Dawn was the only one to do this song.
Dreaming, I must be dreaming. Or am I really lying here with you? Baby, you take me in your arms. And though I'm wide awake, I know my dream is coming true. And oh, I just fall in love again. Just one touch and then it happens every time. And there I go. Just fall in love again, and when I do, I can't help myself, I fall in love with you.
Oh, magic, it must be magic, the way I hold you when the night just seems to fly. I fall in love with you. There I go, I just fall in love again, and when I do, I can't help myself. Fall in love with you. I can't help myself. I fall in love with you.
Ann and I shared the same manager, and he came out to one of my shows and was talking in the dressing room about this project, the Duets project. And I said, oh, that sounds great. I want to sing Danny's song. I think I kind of invited myself onto the project, actually.
People smile and tell me I'm the lucky one, and we've just begun. I think I'm gonna have a son.
She sang the first line, and that voice, you know, I knew she was a stylist, but really standing there next to her and hearing it firsthand, it's just so effortless and so conversational. You feel like she's speaking right to you.
Even though we ain't got money, I'm so in love with you, honey.
I think it's very important when you hear a song, and this has been a part of my criteria for choosing songs, is that you must be moved in some way by it. And whether it's the lyric, sometimes it's the music, sometimes it's just the feel of the thing. But in most cases for me, it was a good lyric.
Pisces Virgo rising is a very good sign. Strong and kind, and the little boy is mine.
just love Danny Song. I picked it because I've always loved that song. I just think it's beautiful, and I've always loved her version of the song. So that was just the first song that came to mind. I thought if I could sing any Anne Murray song with Anne Murray, it would be Danny Song. Even though we ain't got money, the song is definitely makes me think of motherhood. I mean, that's what it's about to me, and that's why I think I relate to it so strongly. I mean, he will be like you and me, free as a dove, conceived in love. I just think that's beautiful.
I remember the first time I sang it live when I was pregnant. I almost couldn't sing it. I got this lump in my throat and the whole thing. So it took on a brand new meaning. And certainly once I had a son, it did for sure. Drink it up. Love a man, he'll bring you luck.
And if you find he helps your mind, you better take him home. Don't you live alone. Try to earn what lovers own.
Even though we ain't got money, I'm so in love with you, honey. Everything will bring a chain of love. And in the morning when I rise, bring a tear of joy to my eyes and tell me everything's gonna be alright.
People smile and tell me
we've just begun.
I think I'm gonna have a son.
You could have knocked me over with a feather that this album would have done this well, probably because it wasn't my idea, which really shows you that I don't always know what's best for me. I gave it a try, but I have to say that I was pulled dragging and screaming into this project, so I can't really take any credit. Except when the work started, because we did work very hard to put this together.
Put on another part of tea. 'Cause I'm in love with the Irish accent to your story.
Working with Anne is her dream, really. She's a true professional. You know, she's so good. She gets her vocal at about one take.
I've been wanting to find a way to record this song again, and Emmylou had recorded it. She recorded it about 10 years after I did on an album, and I knew she knew it, so I thought, perfect opportunity to reintroduce this song.
It comes so close to me today. Put on another pot.
I really hadn't seen her in a really long time, so this was a combination of being able to work on something that was very special, this particular song, and also have a really good visit with her and catch up on a lot of things that have been going on in her lives, like our children growing up.
Not one song on this album was difficult to share. I had no problem sharing it at all. I was so happy to have these people agree to do this thing, and it was nice to see a new slant on all of these songs and different voices singing them.
I completely appreciate her as my mentor. I completely appreciate her as my mother.
Anne definitely has that gift of being able to not only sing a song, but to really tell a story and to really make you feel like she's singing right to you.
If you put on an Anne Murray record, I don't care what decade you're dealing with, you know exactly who's singing. So she has a sound that's indigenous to hers. There's not one person on this planet that I've heard that sounds like her. It's gravel and angel dust. It's weightless and so weighted.
I cried a tear, you wiped it dry. I was confused, you cleared my mind. I sold my soul, you bought it back for me and held me up and gave me dignity. Somehow you needed me, you gave me strength to stand alone again, to face the world out on my own again. Put me high upon a pedestal, so high that I could almost see eternity. You needed me, you needed me. And I can't believe it's you, I can't believe it's true. You were there, and I'll never leave. Why should I leave? I'd be a fool, 'cause I finally found someone who really cares. You held my hand when it was cold, was lost, you took me home, you gave me hope when I was at the end, and turned my lights back into truth again. You even called me friend, you gave me strength to stand alone again, to face the world out on my own again. You put me high upon a pedestal, so high that I could almost see eternity. You needed me, you needed me, you needed me, you needed me.